my children's souls to keep. It seems the world is going crazy, though I need to do my share. Could you please take them under wing, watch over them especially, keeping them safe.
I know you're listening in the silence of the night. The news is blistering, but I hold on to your light. And though there's darkness all around us, by my faith I know you're there. Give me the strength to I feel you here with me as we all face the unknown. Could you return us to your garden
when no one's hurt
and no one's scared?
Free us from pride and bitterness.
Keep us so close we won't forget. Teach us to love as you.
Right hand and holy arm have won the victory. Lord, you have made known your victory. You have revealed your righteousness in the sight of the nations. You remember your steadfast love and faithfulness to the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Shout with joy to the Lord, all you lands. Lift up your voice, rejoice and sing. Sing to the Lord with harp, and with the harp and the voice of song, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Shout with joy before the King, the Lord. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the world and those who dwell therein. Let the rivers clap their hands, and let the hills ring out with joy before the Lord, who comes to judge the earth. The Lord will judge the world with righteousness and the people with equity. The psalmist reminds us this morning that we should shout with joy, that we are to sing a new song to God because God has done marvelous things. God has given us love and faithfulness. God cares about you and me. God fills our lives with love, and that should bring us joy. There's lots of things in the world to be sad about. Lots of bad things happening in people's lives. Lots of death and sickness and heartache and pain. And I've thought a lot about this year about how hard life is for people, even in quote-unquote normal times when there is no pandemic. And we can't ignore this. We should also remember that life is filled with joy, too. There's lots of things in life to give thanks for. There's lots of things that fill our hearts with goodness. Lots of celebrations, life passages, mercy and relief. There's lots of love out there in the world. Lots of it. There are families who work hard every day to stay together. There are people compromising, forgiving each other, trying to do better. There are communities of people that love one another enough to look past your differences and disagreements to do good in this world. There's so many good things about life to celebrate and to be joyful about. It's the other side of the coin. It's the other side of life. We need that side of life in our lives. We can't just go around thinking how awful things are all the time. We need to find joy for ourselves and for those around us. God wants us to be joyful and to know joy. God provides love and faithfulness so that we can know what true joy really is. That is what we're talking about this morning. I'd like to thank Jim for being here to record and Paul for being here to sing. And I'd like to thank Janet for playing the piano and for Paul and for Heather for that really lovely prelude this morning that was recorded. Thank you for that. And so let us begin our worship together with our gathering song, Love Divine, All Love Excelling, number 631.
Chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus Jesus said, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I've called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you. And I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask him in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another." The gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Let us pray. Dear Lord, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight. Amen. This week I got to go out and have dinner with my lifelong best friend. He's my oldest friend. We've been friends since I can remember what a friend is. He's more like, kind of like a brother. He's more like family to me. And we had a great time. It's been a while, but we had a great time. I got to spend time with someone I love. It brought me great joy. A bunch of times this week, I got to spend time with people from our congregation who stopped by here for various reasons. I got to sit and talk about their lives, their struggles, their joys. That's the part of my job that I actually love the most. I love the people that God has given me to serve. It brought me great joy. On my day off, I got to go with another one of my best friends, and we went out and we played golf. We talked about our lives. We worked on our golf games. We've been friends a long time, since we were teenagers. I love spending time with him. It brings me great joy. Also on my day off, I got to cook for my family. We have a special dinner every Friday night. My oldest child invited some of her friends over. We laughed, we ate. I love my family. I look forward to those meals every Friday. It brought me great joy. Jesus tells us this morning that his love abides in us, lives in us. And because of that, we have love that we get to share with others in our lives. And the end result of all of that love is joy. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. Love brings us joy. We don't talk enough about joy in church, actually. Actually, when I'm with my colleagues and we're discussing our ministries, we don't share enough of our joys. We share our struggles, our disappointments, our hopes for what might be. But I'm sad to say that we just don't share our joy enough. It's true, being a faith leader has its challenges, but at the end of the day, I can tell you that it does bring me great joy. I think of all the things I get to do. I get to baptize babies, hopefully some adults along the way. I get to marry people. I get to hang out with kids and teenagers and young adults. I get to be with people as they remember the people who have passed who they love. I get to serve meals to those experiencing hunger. I get to speak up for those experiencing homelessness. What makes all that possible is that those things are done in love. They're done because our congregation loves one another and the community that we serve. Of course, our love is not perfect, but luckily, we know that God's love is. And that's enough, it's plenty, to help us to work together and give us joy. Today, after worship, I'll go out and I'll be with my family for Mother's Day. I'll be around my mom and my sisters and my brothers-in-law and my nieces and nephews. We'll be together, we'll laugh. We'll talk about old times gone by. We'll talk about our lives and what we hope for the future. We'll celebrate that we have been blessed in this life with such a wonderful mother who loved us unconditionally and who provided for our needs. Being around them reminds me just how much love there is in this world. Of course, I also know that today is not the same for everyone. There are those people out there who don't have good relationships with their mother. There's those who always wanted to be a mother. And today is painful because it's a reminder of the things that they don't have. And I'm thinking about those folks today too. What we have in common, though, is that we are loved by the same God.
And it's God's love that gives us joy. I hope all those watching today know that love and have found the joy in their lives. And this morning, I'm just sharing the things in my life, the experiences that I have that God has put in my place that give me joy. You know, I recently went with my mother to make arrangements with the funeral home for when she goes home to be with the Lord. And some people, my friends who are lovely, they called and asked if I was okay. I told them the truth, that my mom and I had a wonderful day together. And I know that that sounds weird, right? I mean, it's kind of a sad thing, but it was a day that brought me joy because we got to be together. We got to share time and share our lives. See, that's my point, is that love is stronger than everything, stronger than anything. And when we share that love with other people, it does bring us great joy. You know, for those who don't know, my mom, she's a person of great faith. I wouldn't be a person of faith without her. She was always the one who insisted that we go to church every Sunday. She is the one who's faithful in her praying and her devotions. She was the one who talked to us kids about God and how important our faith could be. She showed us what a joy it is to be part of a faith community that loves each other. As my older sister says, no one loves Jesus more than Mom. And that is true. It's because of her that I know about God's love. And because of that love, I know what it is to have joy in my life. Jesus is telling his disciples this morning about this because Jesus sees the end of the day. Jesus knows that his death will be hard for his disciples. Jesus knows that after he's gone, it will be harder for them to keep this community going. He knows how petty they can all be. I mean, they're always fighting over who's the best disciple, over who gets to sit at Jesus' right hand. They all don't quite understand what Jesus is doing. They all see him from a little bit of a different perspective. How will they keep this thing going after he leaves? And the only answer Jesus gives is they have to love one another. Whatever else they think or believe or understand about Jesus, that is what is going to keep them together. Love as a verb, love as work, love as working on relationships as we forgive one another, as we take time to try to understand one another. Because that kind of love, it's deep, it's filled with scars, but it leads to joy. It leads to deep relationships that we have with one another. Then in our lives, we're able to find joy in sharing a meal with an old friend, golfing, eating, laughing, just being together. Without love, those things are just normal things that happen. They don't necessarily bring us joy, but with love they do. They're essential for our lives because we can't have death and sickness and heartache and pain all the time. We can't just have the daily grind of getting up and getting everything done. We have to stop and enjoy the people that God has put in our place. And I hope for you today that you know the mothering love of God. I hope you know a love that cares deeply for you and that would do anything for you. A love so profound that it would die for you. And I hope that love today brings joy into your life. Amen. Let us sing together our hymn of the day, Mothering God, You Gave Me Birth, number 735.
Thank you.
In this season of Easter, as we celebrate the death and resurrection of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we confess our common faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Alive in the risen Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Loving God, you call us to be your fruit-bearing church. Strengthen the bonds among all Christian churches. Today we pray for the Moravian Church, giving thanks for the life and witness of Nicholas Ludwig von Zinzendorf, renewer of the church and hymn writer. Hear us, O God. Creating God, the earth praises you. The seas roar and the hills sing for joy. Fill the earth with your love, so that by their song all creatures of land and sea and sky, borrowing and soaring, may call us to join with them in praise. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Faithful Savior, you conquer the world not with weapons, but with undying love. Plant your word in the hearts of the nation's leaders and give them your spirit, so that the people of the world may live in peace. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Caring healer, you forget no one and accompany the lonely. Be present with those who are sick or suffering. We especially pray for David, Edward, Emma, Dorothy, Rebecca, Alva, Gretchen, Adeline, Karen, Bill, Teresa, Kathy, Kim, Ken, Sal, Valerie, Florence, Teresa, Vicky, Gail, Thomas, Ernie, Karen, Gethsemane Lutheran Church, Carol, Nicole, Carol, John, Dean, Mike, Helen, Barbara, Bill, Liesl, and Karen. We pray for those who grieve, the family and friends of Joe, Kathleen, Paul, Tim, Dick, Judy, Grace, and Eric. And remember our homebound Betty Lee, Florence, and our men and women in the service, Isaac, Gus, Daniel, and Joshua. Provide for those needing homes or medical care, and point us towards life-changing responses to those needs in our own communities. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. Gracious God, as a mother comforts her child, you comfort us. Bless mothers and mothering people in our lives. Comfort those who miss their mothers, mothers who grieve, those who grieve because they cannot be mothers, and those who have never known a loving mother. Hear us, O God. Gentle Redeemer, all who die in you abide in your presence forever. Remember with thanksgiving those who shared your love throughout their lives. Keep us united with them in your lasting love. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Hear our own prayers, may be offered aloud or in our hearts. In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. I hope this week you encounter the love of God, and because of that, you know that life is filled with joy. in your friendships, your family, your work, and your play. May God's love surround you and give you joy in your heart. As Carlos Santana once said, if you carry joy in your heart, you can heal any moment. Or Tim Cook, let your love be in your journey, not in some distant goal. Or Helen Keller, joy is the holy fire that keeps our purpose warm and our intelligence in glow. Or in the words from a song by R.E.M., meet me in the crowd, people, people, people. Throw your love around, love me, take it into town, happy, happy, put it in the ground where the flowers grow, gold and silver shine, shiny, happy people holding hands. And I'll leave you today with the lyrics from Joy to the World by Three Dog Night. Singing joy to the world, all the boys and girls now, joy to the fishes in the deep blue sea, joy to you and me. And may our glorious God grant you a spirit of wisdom to know and to love the risen Lord, the God of life, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Let us sing our sending song, Abide, O Dearest Jesus, number 539. Thank everybody for being with us here this morning. I hope in our new song, in our prayers, in our words, you found some joy this week for your journey. If you'd like to support our ministry, you can do that by giving through our PayPal account, which there's a link to in the comments section. I want to thank again Jim for recording, Paul for singing, and Janet for replaying. And now go in peace, share the good news. Thanks be to God.